Hi, I'm Emma. I'm a certified Dubsado specialist, and in this video I want to take you through the settings for your new Dubsado account. So in this video specifically, we're going to talk about receiving payment. So in your settings, you're going to go to this option here called receive money. And so this is where you connect your payment processors to Dubsado. So Dubsado does not process payments on its own. It connects to one of these three, or two of these three if you want, payment processors. So you can connect your account to Stripe and PayPal, or you can connect your account to Square and PayPal. You can also connect it, you know, only to Stripe, only to Square, only to PayPal. But if you want to use two, it's Stripe and PayPal or Square and PayPal. You cannot use Square and Stripe together. So to connect your account to one of these payment processors, the first thing you have to do, so in this account, I've already set my country code and currency, but see, I have Canadian dollar and Canada. So you would select the country and the currency you want to receive in this brand, and you're going to hit save. Then these options are going to pop up and you're going to connect the ones that you want. Okay. So I'm just going to go ahead and connect it to Stripe. So here you're going to put the email that you have your Stripe account connected to. You're going to put in your password, you're going to log in, and you're going to connect the Stripe account that you want to connect to Dubsado. So now if I go back here, you can see that my Stripe account is now linked to Dubsado, and I can disconnect it by clicking this here. So in this case, there's two options in Stripe. You can accept payment via checking or savings, which is called ACH. So for people that are in the US, they can pay via ACH. And then there's credit card. Okay, they charge different processing fees. This first one generally charges less than credit cards, but to double check what those fees are, go to Stripe's website to make sure that you know exactly how much, you know, Stripe is going to take from that payment. So it's not free. Stripe takes about, in my case, it's about a 2.9% when people pay with credit cards off of that total. So you know, when someone transfers, you know, let's say $1,000, Stripe will keep 2.9% of that, and then the rest will flow into my bank account. So the other thing, so you can scroll down here and connect PayPal, and then you also see this option here, which is new to Dubsado. It's called Autopay. So what Autopay does is that if people are paying in several installments, so it doesn't work for pay in full option, but if people are paying in installments or they have recurring invoices, you can enable auto pay so that it deducts automatically from their account every time without them having to go in and, you know, click on the invoice and make a payment, all that stuff. It's just done automatically. So you can see here that it's optional when you start. You can change it and disable it completely if you don't want people to be paying through auto pay, or you can make it required, forcing people to have to register for auto pay in order to work with you. So again, there is no right or wrong. It's whatever works best for you. I know for some people, they have problems getting paid, so they want to make it a required option in their business so that people have to sign up, so that they also have peace of mind knowing that those subsequent installments are going to go through and they're going to get paid on time. The other option here is accepting gratuity. So if people want to give you, you know, gratuity above and beyond what they're getting in, what they're paying in their invoice, you can enable that, and then there will be an option inside of the invoice. So the other thing that isn't that obvious here is this tab here called invoices. So here you can enable the tax column inside of your invoices. For some of you, it doesn't apply, so you can turn it off. You can, you know, decide who the bill to party is. So show the client name or the show the company name or both, whichever works for you. And the most important thing here is editing terms. So you can see I did a quick reel about this, which is why it's enabled here. For a lot of people, especially those who work in the wedding industry, I've noticed, they tend to accept payment via Venmo. So you can put your handle and you can put a link there so that they pay through Venmo or whatever processor you want to use that's beyond Stripe, Square, or PayPal. So you can put that link in your invoice and it will show when someone receives the invoice. It will be at the top if you put it here, or you can put it at the bottom. So if you have wording that needs to appear on all of your invoices, showing the payment terms or your tax code or anything above like your name and address that you need to show in your invoices, you can add that here in the top or the bottom, whichever works best for you. You can put QR codes. I put this e-transfer option for Canada because we can accept payment through e-transfer. Just having, you know, if they know which email to send that payment to, they can do that from their bank account. So all of these are here. And again, just make sure you hit save and then that's set. Every client that receives an invoice from you will have those terms in there, you know, over and over again. They'll all receive those terms. So make sure that anything that you want to have appear in your invoices is added here under edit terms. So that's the gist of all this receive money part inside of your settings. And in the next video, we'll talk about connecting your email address to Dubsado.